Hey friends, hope you're well. In case you missed it, OpenAI today announced ChatGPT Agent, a version of GPT that can perform autonomous tasks on your behalf. This is huge because it goes beyond the chatbot architecture that we all know to taking a big step into the direction of being autonomous by using its own virtual computer and handling complex tasks for you. It builds and improves upon OpenAI's Operator, which was an agent trained to handle the internet's buttons, text fields, and it launched earlier this year. But GPT Agent is a big step forward, and it's absolutely something you should keep your eye on. So here's everything you need to know. So OpenAI claims Agent is significantly more accurate than O3 and deep research models on the browse comp benchmarks, which measures the ability to locate hard to find web information. But what does this actually mean for us? It means GPT Agent is able to plan a dinner reservation by connecting to, let's say, Google Calendar, then finding a free evening in that calendar, then cross-referencing a reservation website like OpenTable to find a reservation and book it at the restaurant. Another example is Agent finding and booking flights for you based on weather, airline preferences, and availability. This might actually sound a lot like Rabbit and Humane promised to do, but we know how that turned out, and OpenAI is definitely in a far better position to deliver on its promises. The entire goal for GPT Agent is to create these sort of seamless interactions between various scaffolding frameworks, and I guess you could see the most ideal version of GPT Agent being something like Iron Man's Jarvis tool. So in OpenAI's launch presentation, they demonstrated a bunch of scenarios and use cases. Some seemed to work well, others not so much. The very first example was a wedding planning task. They gave it prompts to search for suits, hotels, and gifts, and GPT Agent impressively made decisions based on weather on that date, dress code, and it even responded to a user adding that he needs black shoes in size 9.5. OpenAI has trained the model to be more collaborative, so it'll clarify questions and adjust the task accordingly. And for the most part, it seems to work, but I did notice it was really slow to respond.
Okay, so just like it was doing on the web, it's gonna take some time, think about like what's it doing, and it'll kick off the query. And as it's going, it'll take some time to kick it off.
But when it did get it right, it seems to be genuinely useful. They also showed an example of Agent creating a custom sticker order on mobile. So it basically generates an image based on your input, so nothing new there. But the difference is Agent then sends the image to a sticker creation website of your choice and fills out the form and then adds it to cart, essentially automating a few steps for you, which seems quite convenient. OpenAI has achieved this by equipping Agent with a suite of tools that include things like a visual browser that interacts with the web through a graphical user interface, a text-based browser for simpler reasoning-based web queries, and then a terminal and direct API access. So in terms of intelligence level, it hasn't really changed, or it hasn't changed at all. It's still leveraging the 4.0 model, but the charm here is that the unified agentic system is there that's bridging research and action, as OpenAI calls it. It feels like OpenAI has really absolutely stepped up the overall trajectory of GPT as an assistant with this big update. That being said, the demo was far from perfect. For example, they sort of rushed through the segment where Agent produced a travel path to visit all these different baseball games.
So again, like as we have shown throughout the live stream, it uses a multitude of tools, uses container, the terminal, using the browser, working through all the details. It'll probably use, again, back to the browser, figuring out Hello Kitty nights, and then sports stadium and whatnot. Oh, let's see, did I miss that? Oh, there you go, map, building a map. Using code to actually build it out, and then overall we get like a pretty solid result, I think.
And I noticed right at the end of the presentation, one leg of the trip has you visiting the ocean, and I'm not aware of any baseball stadiums over the ocean, but correct me if I'm wrong. Also, financial transactions are restricted for now, and I think rightfully so, because at least until Agent gets to a far more advanced place, and even then, I'm not even sure if I want it to be handling my finances. But the problem I see with all of this is that open-ended tasks require a level of human thought like imagination, thinking outside the box, and sometimes even emotion, like buying a gift for a loved one. The other worry is around privacy, of course, and how it stores or uses the connected platforms to perform these tasks for you on Google Calendar or OpenTable. So it opens a whole new can of worms around AI ethics, but I don't know, what do you think? Is this something you'd actually use? Because ChatGPT Agent is rolling out to Pro Plus members and team users with message caps. Pro users have 400 messages a month while everyone else gets 40 messages a month. And if you hit that limit, there are credit-based options. So as it stands, this marks a pretty big step forward. And even though it is flawed and the demonstration wasn't as smooth as it could have been, let's remember this is Agent Zero and just the beginning of what will likely be a very rapidly transforming AI space. Drop the code word comment agentic and I'll give it a like for making it to the end of this video. And as always, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.